Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. It's Cynic Alex. And today, in light of not having an update for February, it seems as though Netmarble is going with the barrage of events and giveaways and login stuff to compensate for that. And so we had the stuff for Lunar New Year, and we're actually still having the Lunar New Year events for a couple more days. And now we're into the Valentine stuff, which is still like more than a week away. But they've already started announcing for it. You have in your notice tab a couple of different things. One about the Valentine's Day events, which there are four or five of, and the CTP and premium card chance ups. I'll talk about those really quickly because I don't want to give too much light to them. But basically all of the, or most of the coveted premium cards and all four of the CTPs are on chance increased. You might see people posting and saying that this is the time to spend crystals on it, but there is no guarantee, as there always isn't a guarantee. There's no trick to getting CTPs or comic cards. There's no special channel. There's nothing you can do to trick the system, despite what people will tell you. So you can kind of try to ignore the rumors. If you want to gamble, go ahead. I'm not going to stop you, but just know that there's no evidence to explain or to show that you get more CTPs or more premium cards during this event. Frankly, I've never been lucky when they have all of them available, and most if not all of my CTPs of energy have been pulled when it was the only one available. But I did spend more crystals at that time, so that may be the case. If you're curious how much I spent and my crystals dropped, I pulled the comic card chest two or three times, and I pulled the CTP chest three times, and I got nothing every single time. Basically all five or six times I just got five star obelisks and five star cards. So there you go, that's that. As far as the actual in-game stuff going on, there's quite a bit to do, so I want to get through all of it. First of all, in the featured shop, when you go over here to consumables, you'll find that there are the gold purchases back. I love these. I think they're great. Especially the gold special chest, that's absolutely the best one. You want to buy this every day. I know it's a million gold spent, so if you can't donate to your alliance, skip that, but definitely don't skip this. I'm not saying you shouldn't donate to your alliance. I'm just saying if you're tight and you only have to choose one, I would choose this one because the rewards can be pretty fat if you get lucky. Also, the energy is amazing, and you can get a plus on your return if you use tracking mission energy, if you use it on tracking missions, because of how much gold you get back. So it's always worthwhile. I also think it's worthwhile to purchase the uniform kits, Black Antimatter and Chaos Nornstones, but that being said, I have 200 million gold, so I can basically go ham and do whatever I want, whereas you may not be able to do that. But if you do have the gold, I would recommend getting it because all of these items are worthwhile, and it might seem like a lot of gold, but you will be able to farm it back very easily over time, and we don't get these events that often, so you want to take advantage of them. As for me, I'm going to try these out right now. I saved all 10 chests for you guys to open together, so let's see what we get. That one's bad. That one's bad. That one's bad. Well, it's bad for me. It might be bad for some of you. Might be great for some of you guys. That's great. That's good for me. Also good. Oh, wait. No, that one's bad. That one's good. That's amazing. No. I got... Okay, there we go. So that's not bad. First day, 400,000 gold. So it basically cost me only 600,000 gold for a 4-star obelisk, a 3-star obelisk, 20 black antimatter, and then the bunch of stuff that was like 300 gear up kits or whatever. That's fine. But if you were a newer player, you would love those 300 gear up kits. So definitely get on that. As well, in the alliance stuff, I mentioned it. I didn't mention it when it was on, but the donation event is still on. I don't know if today's the last day. You donate, you get double the tokens. And they also have, I think today is last day, yeah. They have special items that you can purchase. So I didn't mention it, but I hope you guys have been doing this. I would be buying the hidden tickets and boost points every single day. Can't really say that the rest of these are good because they're so expensive. This is equivalent to 500,000 gold normally for 15, where the other one was 200,000 gold for 20. So that's why I think it's much better for the other one versus this one here. The next event they have going on, which is pretty synergistic with the gold event because you can get energy, is an energy spending event. And you basically just have to spend 3,000 energy, which is super easy to do, and you get a bunch of free stuff, the hidden tickets being probably the best one. And those hidden tickets will help you get that special mission CTP of destruction faster. Speaking of which, tomorrow, on tomorrow's stream, I'm going to be getting the CTP of destruction. So if you want to see someone complete this live, definitely check that out. Additionally, just to plug my live stream a little bit more on Twitch, I'm also going to be getting Nightcrawler to tier 2. I finally got his last gear to 20, so he's ready to catch a ticket or to catch some bios and be upgraded to tier 2. So we'll be playing around with Nightcrawler a little bit and confirming my suspicions that he's completely garbage. And then maybe taking him up to like level 64 or something like that, because I have so much excess mats in terms of Phoenix Feathers and Emkron Crystals. The next event that I want to talk about is the character ranking event. This one is for Human Torch and Thing. Now, the rewards for these two are different, so you do have to keep that in mind. Most of you will probably have a higher ranking for Human Torch, so you'll think, oh, I'll just focus more on Human Torch and get an even better reward. Well, no. Unless you're in the top like 10 for Human Torch, it's really not worth it because you get Black Antimatter and Chaos Nordstones, but really, even being in the top 50, it's pretty bad, like it's a pretty jokey reward. However, you get 300,000 gold just for being the top 1%, so I would honestly aim low with Human Torch. However, Ben Grimm is a bit different. You get crystals for Ben Grimm, so yeah, you should really try to get those 100 crystals. I mean, the difference between 100 and 80 is not that much, but then you could also aim for rank 777, or if you're close to the top 100 and not that many people have invested in him, you could come away with 250 crystals. It's kind of impressive that they put the bad crystals or the good reward on the possibly bad character or the character that's not as strong individually. But it's good for us, I guess, and it's good for fans of Ben Grimm, so you're going to be getting some crystals really soon. Additionally, they also have a new check-in event. They've got a 7-day check-in that's going to give us a platinum box, 100,000 gold, and a fully awakened ISO, which is nice. And this, of course, always stacks with the regular Fantastic Four login and the monthly check-in. Additionally, I know, right? They're also going to be giving us another platinum box, I believe, and as well as vibranium boxes, which usually have like gear up kits or materials in them, but these vibranium chests will be given much closer to Valentine's Day. So we still have about a week or less than a week, 5 days until we see those gifts, but you'll get one in your account. So just open it and you'll get something good. Hopefully maybe some of you will get like a tier 2 ticket or something crazy like that. As for me and my chest, I have the second last day's worth of Lunar New Year gift chests. So I'm gonna open these. By far the best rewards from these for me have been these uniform upgrade tickets. I love these. They're very nice to use, especially on premium characters. If you know, Killmonger or Carnage gets a uniform, or Spider-Man 2099, really nice way to just bump up a uniform quickly to legendary or heroic so that you can start that final grind to mythic. So we're gonna pop all these right now and see just what we get. I haven't had much luck on the stream with the Twitch guys, so I'm thinking maybe between you and me on YouTube we'll have a little bit more success. And we did. We got a 2-star. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted. Can we get another one? Can we get a 1,000 likes in this video? No, we only got one, but that's awesome. That's really, really good. Web resist, no. Ignore dodge. I might actually roll that ignore dodge up to 6 stars. So yeah, thank you guys for the luck on that. Let me know what you guys think of all of these events. This doesn't compensate for skipping an entire update, but we probably wouldn't have gotten a big update anyways. We would have gotten something with one or two characters, two or three uniforms, and maybe we would have gotten tired of that uniform after a couple of days anyway. So let me know. Finally, just really quickly, I want to discuss, there's a new pack in the shop. I almost forgot about this mega upgrade pack. I don't think I've ever seen this one before. Short story, it's not good. We had the same deal in the store a couple of days ago as part of the tiered sale. It's tiered because it has this little triangle thing here. It's not this one though, it was the one before that. Yes, you had to purchase the $6 one and or the $5 one and the $10 one, but for the same price as this, it was 3,300 crystals, which is 1,100 more. It's you know, literally double or 1.5 times, and it gave the mega rank up and the mastery and the gold, and it had boost points. So yeah, I would steer clear of this. It's not worthwhile. And just save up your crystals to get the mega rank up when it's on sale for 2,600 crystals for the tiered sale itself. And then everything else on sale is just not that great. You should steer clear of it as well. So with that being said, let me know if this comes close to compensating for an update for you guys. Subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want to support me. Hit me up on Twitch for more. And of course, if you like what you see, I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.